right, you guys, come down to your mat. Take your knees extra wide. Walk your hands forward. Hi, Jane.
Okay.
Start to breathe your body. Hello, Jennifer S. Welcome. Deep, full breath in. Nice, big breath out. Hi, Lisa S. Welcome. Guy in the building. I love it. Anne's cat giving her some love while she's in child's pose. So start to settle in here, you guys. Take your attention off of your day and bring your attention right here to your breath. And create depth, sound, stillness. And spread your fingers really wide and press down through your finger and your thumbprints. Perhaps that gives you access to a little longer spine. Pull the pit of your belly in towards your spine, and perhaps your hips sink a little closer towards your heels. And take a couple more breaths. No rush to get to the next place, just enjoying the right here, the right now. Hey, Beth, take one more big breath in. Empty, make your way to downward facing dog. Perhaps your first down dog today, there's Beth, hi. Maybe it's not your first downward facing dog, but meet it with the intention of getting set in your foundation. Push through your hands and your feet. Hug in at your low belly. And set your two eyes on a single spot and just breathe. I really love to bend my knees a bit in the first downward facing dog of the day. It gives me room to lengthen my spine. That's it, Christine. So nice. All right, so a little ease in my hamstrings, a little more spinal length. Take a big breath in. Empty, walk your hands back towards your feet and take ragdoll at the back of your mat. Yes, McGuire's, you guys did that together as a team. Grab opposite elbows and let your upper body drift towards the floor. If there's tension in your neck or your shoulders, perhaps a little shake side to side. And take a full breath in. Let go of your elbows, put your hands on the mat, and walk out to the top of a push-up. High plank. All right, action your legs. So I have to remind myself to do this. Pull your leg muscles into your bones and create internal rotation from the inside edges of your heels to your upper thighs. Rotate your thighs upward. And hey, Catherine R., welcome. Pull your leg muscles into your bones any amount more. Soften your elbow joints. Take a big breath in. Empty, lift your hips, downward facing dog. Look forward, step your feet towards your hands. One more ragdoll, the same bind, or interlace your hands behind your back. Lighten the load of your toes. All right, so lift and spread your 10 toes out on the mat. Anchor instead through the four points, the base of your big toe mound, your pinky toe mound, your inner and outer heels. And drop your head weight. Drop any contents inside of your head. Especially if you're outside, just take a big breath in, fresh air. Exhale all of your air. Let go of your bind, you guys. Walk your feet together. Reach up, high mountain. Stretch your hands towards the sky or the ceiling that is above you. Push down into your feet. Notice that space between your feet and your mat. Stretch up any amount more. All right, drop your hands to heart center, your gaze towards your fingertips, and let's connect our voices, mine and yours for sure. You'll hear those two. Take a deep breath in. Empty out. Breathe in for om. Smile because you are at yoga. Inhale, reach up, big stretch. Hinge at your hips, bow forward, chest towards your thighs. Halfway lift, lengthen your spine. Plant your hands, high plank and lower. Upward facing or cobra, you decide, really nice. And downward facing dog, lift your hips away from your palms. All right, and focus less on the lift and more about grounding down through your hands and your feet. The pushing down lifts you up. And as you press through your hands, lift your shoulders up and out of your ears. So good. Take a big breath in. Look forward. Move very lightly, feet to hands. Halfway lift. Fold forward. From your feet up, high mountain stretch. Exhale, fold forward. Nice, lift halfway. Plant your hands high to low plank on your exhale. Upward facing, breathe in. Downward facing dog, breathe out. Send your chest a little closer towards your inner thighs and press your heels a little closer to your mat. Breath in. Breath out. What's available when you simply breathe and choose to be right here? And take one more breath in. Look to your hands, step or hop. Lift halfway. Fold forward. High mountain, breathe in. Bow, breathe out. Halfway lift, shoulders towards your spine, hands to the mat, high to low. So good, Ellie. Upward, broaden your chest. Downward facing dog, press your chest towards your thighs. And soften your eyes and soften your jaw. And paying attention to whether you are efforting more or you're more relaxed, and find that lane down the middle. Strength plus ease. Breathe in. Empty, look forward, travel halfway. Fold, high mountain, breathe in. Bow, breathe out. Half lift, lengthen and flatten. Chaturanga, low plank. Upward, action your legs. Downward facing dog, soften something. Right, I have found in the last few weeks that I'm either working really, really hard or totally at ease, and that middle has been a little more challenging to get a hold of. So bring the thing you could use a little more of right now. Take a huge breath in. Look to your hands, go. Half lift. Nice, Katie, fold. Reach up, stretch, Jennifer C. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway lift, low plank, upward facing, broaden your chest, downward facing dog, lift your hips. Take three breaths, fill. Empty. Breathe in. Breathe out. And take one more breath, lengthen first, look forward, move, half lift, bow. Chair pose, sit low, reach high, lengthen both sides. Exhale, fold forward. So good, you guys. Lift halfway, lengthen. Chaturanga flow. Upward facing, press your index knuckles down. Downward facing dog, step your right foot forward, warrior one, rise. Plant your hands, low plank. Upward, action your hands to lift your chest. Downward. Step your left foot forward, warrior one. Ground down, reach from there. Exhale, chaturanga. Upward facing, breathe in. And downward facing dog, breathe out. Notice how you've shown up today. Right? If your attention is on how hard it is or how easy it is, just set your attention to your breath. And choose not to label it one way or the other way. And breathe in together. Look forward, go. Halfway lift, fold, chair pose, sit low. Bow, half lift, low plank. Upward facing, press the toenail sides of your feet down. Downward facing, right side, warrior one. Exhale, low plank. Ride your breath, you guys. Upward, lift your heart. Downward facing dog, left side, anchor down, rise. Plant your hands, flow with some ease. Upward, perhaps a little grin. Downward facing dog. Take a big breath in and out. Breathe in. Breathe out. So many Jennifers here with us today. If your name is Jennifer, smile at the other Jennifers. Yeah, that even if they can't see you, take a big breath in. Look to your feet, step or hop. JC just waved to the Jennifers, half lift. Fold, Utkatasana, ground your heels. Fold forward, Uttanasana. Halfway lift, Chaturanga. Upward facing, strong legs. Downward facing dog, right side, warrior one. One breath up. Exhale, right back down, low plank. Nice, Jessica. Upward, lift your heart. Downward, hips high, left side, from the floor to your core through your fingers. Chaturanga flow. Upward, breathe in. Downward facing dog, breathe out. Three breaths, fill up. Empty fully. Breathe in. Empty again. And take one more breath. Get light. Travel forward. Halfway lift. Fold. Utkatasana. Uttanasana. Halfway lift. Chaturanga. Upward. Smile. Downward. Smile. Right side, warrior one. Exhale, low plank. Upward, breathe in. Downward, breathe out. Left side, warrior one. Lisa L., it looks like Lincoln arrived from the library. Chaturanga Dandasana. Upward, breathe in. And downward facing dog, breathe out. Two breaths. Fill up and lengthen. Exhale, get light, hop forward, feet to the top, halfway lift. Bow. Chair pose. Fold forward. Half lift. Low plank. Upward, press your feet. Downward, lift from your core, right side, warrior one. Exhale, Chaturanga. Nice, Betsy. Under the trees, upward facing dog. Downward facing dog, left side, warrior one. Exhale, low plank. Upward, breathe in. Downward, breathe out. Take one breath in. Get totally empty. Let it go. Look forward, feet to hands. Last sunbeam, halfway lift. Fold. Chair, lowest seat found right here together. Fold. Half lift. Chaturanga. Upward, breathe in. Downward, breathe out. Right side, Virabhadrasana one. Exhale, Chaturanga. Yes, Amy, lift your heart, breathe in. Lift your hips, breathe out. Left side, warrior one. Exhale, low plank. Do you feel alive? The answer is yes. Lift your heart upward. Lift your hips, downward facing dog. Are you sweating yet, Jennifer D? Is it happening? Okay, good. Jennifer D said, I'm ready to sweat, Kim. Push through your hands and feet. Bring your toes close. Lift your right leg up. Bend your knee. Fire hydrant. Anchor through your right hand, you guys. Like push through both hands equally. Here, you can stay or flip your dog. Shoulders over wrist. Land your lifted right foot. Lift your left hip up as much as your right hip. That's it. So good, Lisa S. Spin your inner thighs towards the mat beneath you and see if you can lift any higher. Take one more breath. Exit three-legged dog. Pause right here. Press your right heel away from your right hand. Rotate your inner right thigh towards what is above you. Breathe in. Rock forward, knee to nose. Inhale, lengthen. Cross to your left. Nice, Jane. Inhale, get long. Knee high on your right tricep. Inhale, lengthen. Knee to nose. Pause right here. Hug in. Use your core. Puff your back up towards the ceiling or sky. Look forward. That's it, Christine. Plant your front foot. Crescent lunge. Rise up. Stack your front knee over your front heel. Yes, Catherine, you are reaching up so high. Hi, it looks as if you're touching your ceiling fan. That's so good. Sit a little deeper in your front knee. Take a breath in. Reach back and humble your crescent lunge. Broaden. All right, today, from here, land your left hand, open arm crescent twist. Plant your left hand on the floor, reach your right hand up into the air. Now, right here, I drop all my weight into my bottom hand. Action your legs, yogis. Action your core. All right, your left hand is not supporting you on its own. All right, keep your arms just like they are. Press into your feet and rise up. A standing, twisting crescent lunge. Left hand towards the top edge of your mat. Right hand towards the back of your mat. You're just in crescent, both feet on the floor, hands reaching front and back. Yeah, twist your chest towards the right side of your mat. Take your gaze back towards your right fingers. Take one more breath. Empty crescent. Reach both hands up into the air. Open up warrior two. Yeah, just a little different variation. Notice if you loved it or hated it, and then just be okay with that. Sit deeply in your front knee and anchor through the pinky toe edge of your back foot even more. All right, your left arm is as strong as your right arm. Sit a little deeper. Reverse your warrior. Reach your left hand, your right hand back. Can slide your left hand down your back leg or reach and take a half bind, catching the top of your right thigh from your backside. Yeah, take one more breath, everyone. Side angle, land your right hand or your right elbow. Reach your left hand up into the air. Press through your feet and hug in at your core. So a strong foundation is the key to every posture. It is also the key to living my life right now, like being grounded. Root down and stretch your top hand past your ear, extended side angle. From your left pinky toe to your left longest fingertip, there's just all this space. And then the next time you breathe, more space. Mm-hmm. So good, you guys. Take one more breath. Look down, hands to the mat, high plank, toes close, side plank on your left. Left hand on the mat, right hand in the air. And you adapt. If you need more, lift your top leg. Pull the pit of your belly in towards your spine. Let your core be a part of the shape. And then get out of your brain. Land in your body. What's going on there? Take one more breath. Land your right hand, lower your body, chaturanga. Nice, you guys. Upward, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale all of your air. And take a big breath. Empty out. And bring your toes close. Fire hydrant on your left. Lift your left leg, bend your knee, stack your left hip on top of your right. Push into the earth with all three points, both hands and your right foot. And stay or go. Ellie's there. Rock your shoulders over your wrist. Flip your dog. Flippers, push through the four points of both feet. And reach your left hand forward, perhaps all the way to the ground. Nice, Amy. Take one more breath. Exit, three-legged dog. Square your hips. Point your left toes towards the mat. That will help with the internal rotation. Take a big breath in. Rock forward, knee to nose. Inhale, three-legged dog. Cross, right tricep. Nice, Sarah. Inhale, three-legged dog. Bring your knee high towards your left tricep. Hug in. Yes, inhale, three-legged. Knee to nose, pause right here. Choose not to clench your jaw. Relax your tongue in between the roof and floor of your mouth. Hug in, lift a little higher, look forward. Step through, crescent lunge. Nice, Kate. Reach your hands high towards the sky and sit deeply into your front knee. Action your back leg. Push the back of your right thigh towards what's above you. Take a big breath in. Reach back and humble your crescent lunge. Broaden your chest, right? Slide your shoulder blades closer towards your thoracic spine. From here, open arm twist. Land your right hand on the mat. Inside of your left foot, send your left arm up into the air. Push into your feet and action your legs so your right hand is not working solo. And every breath in, longer spine, and every breath out, you twist a little bit more. All right, your arms are gonna stay where they are. Your feet are gonna stay where they are. Just simply push into your feet and come upright. Your right hand forward, your left hand back. A big open arm crescent twist. Stretch your fingertips away from one another. Nice, Jennifer Downs. Hello, Zen. Take one more breath right here. Twist towards your left side any amount. Inhale, reach both hands up, crescent lunge, and then open up warrior two. Spin your back heel down. Aha. Drop your tailbone and pull the pit of your belly in and up. So you're working neutral spine here. Some days in warrior two, my front ribs are all blown out and my back has a huge sway. Find a neutral spine. Hug your belly towards your spine. Flip your left palm, reverse your warrior, reach back. And track your front knee right over your front middle toes. And take one more breath. Side angle pose, land your left hand or your left elbow, reach your right hand up into the air. And stretch the crown of your head away from your right heel. And then extend your side angle. Reach your top hand past your ear, stretch. On my screen, Jane, you and Kate are rocking this extended side angle right next to one another. Take one more breath, you guys. Biggest stretch found right here in this breath. Plant your hands on the mat, high plank, into side plank on your right. Anchor your right hand, lift your left. And then notice, push through your right index knuckle, your right thumb knuckle, pull in at your belly and see what's possible right there. And I tend to lean back a little. If I roll my top hip open, it's easy. If I really want to work, stacking top hip on top of bottom hip requires action. Hard to do when you're getting dog kisses. Take one more big breath in. Plant your top hand, high plank to low plank. Upward, pull your heart through, lift your chest. Downward, facing dog, take one breath in. Exhale it out, look forward, step your feet to the top of your mat, lift halfway. Fold forward, chair pose, Utkatasana. So for just a moment there, Katie, the screen glitched and it looked like you were floating for like 3 seconds. It was awesome. Sit lower, everybody. Lengthen your left and your right side. All right, reach back. Humble your crescent lunge. Just long enough to get broad and wide. If you want to lift your heels for a second ski, go for it. Connect your hands. Twist your chair towards the right. Left arm outside of your right thigh. And check your body out in space. So notice if your hips are higher than your heart, you want to drop them lower. And breathe in. And breathe out a few more breaths here. If you want to lower your left hand and reach up through your right, go for it. If you're itching for right side crow, go for that. And breath in. Nice, Lisa. Breathe out. Lower your feet. Separate them. Parangustasana. Peace finger bind your big toes. And rock your hips over your heels and press your chest towards the space of your legs. And breathe in. Breathe out. Take one more breath. All right, let go of your toes. Walk your feet together. Rise up, high mountain. Let's build it this time from high down to low. Sit your butt back into chair pose. Nice, you guys. Lengthen from the creases of your hips through your fingertips. Take a breath in. Reach back and humble. You are welcome to lift your heel ski or even straighten your legs and go for the dive, which is really fun and a little scary because there's some wobble. Mm-hmm. Take one more breath. Empty, hands to heart center. Twist your chair towards your left. All right, check it out. Uddiyana Bandha, super strong. Internal rotation of your thighs, also building strength. And from right here, you create. Right hand down, left hand high to split your wings. Left side crow. The inner edge of your left knee will balance on your right tricep. It's like a pivot point, and you lean into it. And you lift your hips off the floor. Maybe you lift your right foot away from your left foot and straighten your upper leg. Yeah. Take one more breath in. Okay, land your feet, gorilla asana. Separate them at least hip distance. Wider is awesome as well. Slide your palms under your feet. And give your head a little shake from side to side and front to back. Mm-hmm. You guys look good doing that all together. All right, release your left hand, release your right hand, crow pose. A single crow today. So set yourself up near the top edge of your mat. If you're interested in making it fancy, you're welcome. Hands rooted, finger and thumb prints grounded. Bring your knees high to your upper, outer triceps. Look forward, lean into it. All right, press the inner edges of your feet together. All right, a little bonus action here in Power Max on a Monday night. If you're really strong in crow and you want to work a little variation, bring your right toes and tap your right wrist. Yeah, and then you'll bring your feet right back together and you'll separate them. Take your left toes and tap your left wrist. And then bring your feet right back together. So good, you guys. Take two more breaths. Elizabeth is rocking tripod headstand outside. Last breath in. Malasana, lower your feet, yogi squat. And bring your hands to heart center. And you can even take the backs of your hands together if that feels nice as a little opposite wrist stretch from the crow work. Yeah, Sarah is showing that to you on the screen right now if you can see her. All right, take one more breath. Empty, push into your feet and stretch all the way up. High mountain, reach towards what is above you. Press your feet down into the floor. And take your arms out in front of you, right side eagle. Squeeze in towards your midline. And soften a part of your face. Equanimity, ease is so much simpler for me when I find it at some point physically. When I'm all clenched, equanimity is tougher to find. Move towards your midline and soften simultaneously. Take two more breaths. Sit a little lower if that's possible, and it is. Inhale, unwind, reach up and stretch. It's undoing. Arms out in front, left side eagle. Nice, Diane and Isabel. Cross your left leg over. Squeeze your thighs into one another. Pull the pit of your belly in and up. And go to today's edge. Not minding anything that is showing up. And take two more breaths. Inhale, unwind, reach up, big giant stretch. So Jennifer V, Kevin, I can't see you guys, but stretch way up high. And bring your hands through heart center, catch your hips. Lift your right knee up to hip height, then decide on a bind. Hand to the front of your knee or peace finger bind your right big toe and extend your foot out in front of you. Anchor through your standing left foot to get a little taller and then swing your knee or your heel towards the right side of your mat, the right side of your room. Now, no matter what bind you have, be rooted in foundation and active in your lifted foot. Really nice, Isabel. Nice, Ellie. And take your gaze over your left shoulder. Just see what happens. Nice, Liz. Take one more breath. Come to center. Release your bind and keep your leg lifted. Keep it high. Palms alongside your body facing the top edge of your mat. Inhale together. Exhale, airplane. Hinge at your hip. Shoot your right foot back. Action your lifted leg planes even more than your standing one. Try that on. Nice, Lisa's. Both of you look like a giant capital T until I said something, right, Lisa S? Broaden your chest. Fly. Take a big breath in. Connect your palms. Half moon. Lower your left hand. Reach your right hand up into the air. Yeah, Jennifer S. is using a water bottle as a prop, and it's perfect. Press into your left hand, your left foot. Lift your right hand, your right foot a little higher. You're just going for the biggest version of yourself without any thoughts around what that looks like. Zero concern for looking good. Go really big. Breathe in. Standing splits. Lower your right hand. Keep your right leg lifted. All right, a few breaths here. Like if you didn't know how many, where would you go? I don't know what's happening tomorrow or the day after, and it just matters how I show up right here. And take one more breath. Bring your right knee towards your chest like a flamingo, and then put your foot on the ground, ragdoll. Shake it. It all out. It feels nice to take fists to your outer hips after all of that standing on one leg. And sometimes it feels good to sway a little side to side. Anne is rocking that version. Breathe in. Breathe out. Bring your toes close, high mountain. Right into your bind. Lift your left leg, hand to knee, or wrap your left big toe with your peace fingers and extend. Anchor through your standing foot and stand up taller. Swing your leg to the left. You can reach your right arm out as a counterbalance, but I invite you to take your eyeballs to the right. Active lifted foot, wherever it is in space. Take one more breath. Come to center. Keep your knee lifted, palms facing the top edge of your mat alongside your body. Stand tall. Breathe in. Transition airplane pose. Your arms, your legs really strong. Your face really relaxed because what happens right here doesn't matter, right? Breathe your body. Broaden your chest. You want to lift it up slightly so that you're an airplane cruising at a nice altitude, not a crashing. And take one more breath. Bring your hands through heart center, half moon. Lower your right hand this time. Prop, no prop. Jane rocked spider fingers when she did the last round. Yeah, and she's doing it again. Look at that. Press down into the floor and lift up, you guys. You're just showing up breath by breath as the biggest version of yourself. Take one more breath in. Standing splits. Lower your left hand. Keep your left leg lifted really strong. Push into the floor and lift from here and then go wherever you'd like to go. Might be handstand kick-ups. A few of you are doing that. Nice, a little kicking up hops. So good, you guys. Take one more breath. Pull your knee towards your chest, ragdoll, plant your left foot on the ground. Take the variation that serves you. Jamie, Andre, I cannot see you on camera, but I trust right here that your skull is super heavy. Let it go. Mm-hmm. Take a big breath in. Empty, walk your feet together. Reach up, high mountain. King Dancer on your right. Turn your right palm towards the right side of your mat, your thumb towards the back of your mat, and catch the inside of your ankle. Kick your foot up. Move your right shin towards the back and pull your right shoulder towards the front of the room. Breathe. You guys are nice looking dancers. Take one more breath. Empty, very gently lower your right hand, lift your left and stretch up. And then lower your left hand, catch the inside of your left ankle. So turn your hand 180 degrees, Lisa S. Yeah, so your thumb is towards the front. That's it. Root down and kick up. Rotate your inner left thigh towards what is above you. Two more breaths. Betsy, so beautiful. Take one more. Inhale, high mountain. Tree pose on the right side. Push your right foot into your standing left leg. Start with your standing foot, you guys. Can you root it down more? Push into your mat, the floor beneath it, the earth beneath it. Hug in and then grow your tree. And perhaps you take your gaze up and put a little tiny mini back bend in here. Lift your heart up as you push through your standing left foot. So good, Sarah. So nice, Jennifer D. Take one more breath. All right, land your right foot and switch your sides. Set your foundation, grow roots beneath your right foot. Make a really strong connection between your lifted foot and your standing leg. Enough that you feel your right quads come to life and grow from there. So good, Catherine. So good. See a couple of cactus arms. See some interlaced hands behind the back. So many beautiful variations. Take one more breath, everybody. And land your left foot on the mat. Bring your hands to heart center. Gaze to your fingertips. Take a breath in. Take a breath out. And inhale, high mountain. From the floor, up you go. Hinge at your hips. Forward fold. And halfway lift. Lengthen first. Hands to the mat, high to low plank. Upward, breathe in. Downward, breathe out. Step your right foot forward, warrior two. And pull your biceps and your triceps into your upper arm bones. And pull the pit of your belly in towards your spine. And marry all of that with some ease, right in between your eyebrows. Between your shoulder blades, sit a little deeper. Nice, straighten your right leg, triangle. Kick your left hip back, lengthen your right side. From your hip crease, knees to your right fingertips. Land your right hand. Go. And push down into foundation, both feet. Your core. And as you lift your top hand, set your gaze in the spot where your neck feels as lengthy and as easeful as it can. And breathe in together. Empty out. Press into your feet. Rise up. Wide-legged forward fold. Turn your right toes towards the left side of your mat. Keep your feet as wide as perhaps your wingspan. And bring your hands to your hips. Lift your heart up. Fold forward on your exhale. And go. And release your hands down to the mat. And set your hands and your elbows approximately shoulder distance. Lengthen your spine. Press your chest towards the window of your legs. So good, Kate. Kate's hips just moved right over her hips. Breath by breath, you're in the flow of this shape, of this practice, of your life. Is that Buddy? And take one more breath, deepest fold. Press down into your feet, rise up, pyramid. Turn your right toes towards the top edge of your mat and point your left toes towards the upper left corner. Square your hips, like bring your hands to your hips, feel both of them pointing forward. Lift your heart up, hinge and fold. Keep both sides of your body long. When you get folded, you can release your hands to the floor. A block underneath my hands is my current fave in pyramid pose. Lengthen your whole spine and then press your chest a little closer to your right inner thigh, your right big toe. So good, Anne. Really nice. Take one more breath. And plant your hands, high plank, top of your push-up. All right, in between sides, just a little core because you guys are strong. Spin your inner thighs towards the ceiling. Take a huge breath in. Rock forward, lower halfway down. Inhale, back to high plank. Lift your hips, downward facing dog. All right, nice and simple, no surprises. Strong legs, high plank. Exhale, low plank. Inhale, high plank, downward facing dog. Two more like that, high plank, strong. Low, strong. High plank, downward facing dog. All right, with the most ease on your face you can bring, high plank. Exhale, low plank. Breathe in high, downward facing dog. Take a big breath in, open your mouth, let the breath out of you. Step your left foot forward, warrior two. Effort plus ease, find both. Reach out through your right hand as much as your left hand. Keep that action in your wingspan. Triangle, straighten your left leg. Kick your right hip back, lengthen your left side. Land your left hand gently. This shape is one of my favorites, just because there's so many beautiful little tweaks that I can create to make me feel good and strong. Push through your left big toe mound. And push through the outer edge of your back foot. Perhaps a little ray of sunlight gets underneath your right arch. Lift your top hand and spread your top fingers. So good, Christine. Take one more breath. Empty it. Press into your feet. Rise up. Turn your left toes. Wide-legged forward fold. Anchor through your feet. Exhale. Bow forward into it. All right, you got so many options here. You can hug your big toes with your peace fingers. You can interlace your hands behind your back. You can float up into tripod headstand. And by all means, you can stay exactly where you are. You don't have to do any of those things. Nice, Beth. If your feet are in the air for tripod, Lower slowly. Perhaps there's a 1 second hover before you land. Working your heels to the mat first today, maybe. And take one more breath. And press into your feet, rise up. Pyramid, square your hips. Easier for me if there is space from left to right between my feet. Catch your hips, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold forward. And press into foundation and use your breath. Breath by breath, this pose is different. Press through your feet and isometrically drag them towards one another, like you could put a wrinkle in the middle of your mat and then fold a little deeper. Why not? You're here after all. And take one more breath, deepest fold. Bring your hands to the mat and step back to high plank pose. All right, choice. Before we move forward, by we, I do mean you, I'm sitting. Before you rock forward and land on your belly, put the number like 5 in your brain. Action your legs, your core. To the count of 5, you can rock some chaturanga push-ups, or you can transition very slowly from this high plank all the way down to your belly. Nice, Jessica, V squared. When you get to 0, rest on your mat. Reach your hands back by your hips. Rest a cheek on the floor. Take a big breath in and out. And then bring your forehead center to the mat. Your pubic bone into your mat. Inhale, locust, shalabhasana. Lift your upper and your lower body. Action your feet. Right, so my preferred version of action is what I like to call flointing. I did not create it, someone else did. Pointed feet and flexed toes. Whatever serves you, action your feet, lift another inch of your legs. Really nice, Maggie, lift another pair of your ribs while you're at it. Woo-hoo, strong backs. Take one more breath. Lower slowly, rest your other cheek on your mat. Take a breath in. Take a breath out. Locust round 2, interlace your hands behind your back. Press your bound knuckles towards your feet. Anchor your pelvis down and lift your upper and lower body. Lift your bound hands away from your back. Use your bound hands to broaden your chest and to lengthen. Two more breaths, you guys. What is possible if you just go for it? Nice, Amy. Take one more breath. Lower slowly. Fill up your lungs. Empty them out. All right, locust is available. Or bend your knees for floor bow. Reach back and catch the tops of your feet. Flex your feet towards the ceiling. Anchor down. Rise up. Go. Relax your bottom lip. Relax your eyebrows. So if your eyebrows are doing the lifting, like currently your eyebrows are at your hairline, lower your eyebrows. I see you. Root down and lift higher. Kick your shins away from your heart. So good, guys. Last breath in. Lower slowly. Bend your knees if they are not, and very gently drop your shins side to side. All right, press through tabletop, swing your feet around, bridge pose. Otherwise known as a beautiful moment to take a sip of water. Right, Anne? I dig it. Also a really good time to give your pet a pet. Yes. All right, set your feet at hip distance. Anchor through both feet. On your inhale, bridge pose, lift your hips away from the ground by pushing your feet into the floor. And spin your inner thighs towards your mat. And then snuggle your shoulders underneath you a bit more, allowing your chest to broaden. And breathe in. Chin to chest, lower slowly. All right, take a breath. Into your breath, bridge round two. On your inhale, go for it. Rise up. If you are itching to go straight to full wheel, go for it. Those of you in bridge, interlace your hands behind your back. Lisa, how did you know? Press your bound knuckles towards the space between your heels. And then rock your shoulders underneath you even more. Yes. Go for the widest collarbones you've had all day. The opposite of zooming. Kate, looking good. Take a big breath in. Chin to chest, lower slowly to the mat. All right, turn your dial to yes. And if full wheel is available, yes it is. Push down, go up, rise. Press the floor away from you. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take one more breath. Lift your hip points closer to what's above you. Lower slowly. Fill up your lungs. Empty out your lungs. If you are in your way, get out of your way. Wheel round whatever round we're on. I lost count. Press down, rise up. Yes, Liz. So nice. Katie, Amy, you guys are rocking wheel right beside of one another. Yeah, so like doing it together. Press down, lift up. Chin to chest, lower nice and slowly. Take a breath in. Empty your air. All right, how about one more, you guys? Thumbs up, a big yes for one more. Do it, let's go. Push down, rise up. All right, you guys, I'm gonna unmute us because I can. We're gonna hold this final back bend to the count of six. Let's count together. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Lower slowly, Supta Baddha Konasana. Good work, you guys. Rest the hand on your belly, hand on your heart. Close your eyes for just a moment and let your eyeballs relax in their sockets. The floor has you, so let go. A couple of you getting dog kisses in Supta Baddha Konasana. I can't think of anything better. Unless like maybe ice cream fell from the sky. I don't know. And take a big breath in. Empty your air, bring your knees together. Pull your right thigh in, press your left heel away at a hover. Pull and press. So it looks like active feet. It looks like a little grin on your face. And a lot of love to your low back. Switch your sides. Hug your left thigh in, press your right heel away at a hover. Nice, Ellie. It's like your right foot is giving me a high foot five. Bam. All right, hug both knees in. Big squeeze. All right, send your feet straight up. Bring your hands behind your head. Rest your skull in your finger and your thumbprints. If you prefer to interlace, go for it. Lift your upper body, shoulder blades away from the mat, chin to chest, pulse straight up. 10, 9, work from your core. Your neck is long, like an extension of your spine. 7, 6, 5, 4. Nice, JC. 3, 2, 1. Bend your knees and go right to a bicycle ride. The exhale lifts your elbow to your opposite knee. The inhale, you lower back down. 10, 9, 8. Active legs. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, feet in the air, pulse up for 8, 7, chin towards your ceiling, 6, 5, 4, yes, Jennifer S, 3, 2, 1, bend your knees, bicycles for 8. Single digits are like no big deal, don't you think? 6, Five, four, go, Beth, go. Three, two, one, feet straight up, pulse up for six. Five, lift your shoulder blades and the corners of your mouth. Three, two, one, last bicycle, six, five, four. Yes, Maggie, lift. Three, two, one, hug your knees into your chest. Big squeeze right here. And drop your knees to the left. Stretch your right arm towards your right. Ah. And let go here. Drop the weight of your shoulders. Drop the weight of your concerns. Just breathe in, out, in, out. One more breath. Knees through center, knees move to the right. Your left arm travels to the left, and so does your chin and your gaze. Breathe in, come to center. And bring your hands behind your thighs and rock and roll up and back. Get some momentum going. So from the top of your spine to the bottom, a few rocks. When you have enough momentum to cross your ankles and step back, move through vinyasa. And pause in your cobra or your up dog. A pause as in two breaths, three might even be more awesome. Strong legs, easeful jaw. And take a huge breath in and out. From your core, lift your hips if you're not there already. Half King Pigeon on your right, lift your right leg really high. Sweep your right knee to the back of your right wrist. Flex your right foot. Yeah, and then inch your left leg way back. And stretch it long. Rotate it internally. So what helps me get there is thinking about all five of my left toenails grounded on the floor and both of my hip points facing down. And then when you're ready, fold onto your forearms, a block. For the next few breaths, there's nothing to do but breathe. Monotasking. And then the monotask of freedom to be 100% present. And that could look like letting your thoughts go or letting go of any clenching in your body. And perhaps a notice of how you feel and a letting that go too. And take three more breaths. One more big breath into the bottom of your lungs. Empty out completely. And walk your hands under your shoulders. Press into down dog or fire hydrant. Child's pose is always available. Other side, lift your left leg, sweep your left knee forward. Take your time, do not let me rush you. Put all of the things in, square hips, internal rotation of your back leg. length of your spine. Move towards the stillness. In the stillness, there's no doing, only breath. All the freedom to be just as you are and just as you are not. There is not a thing to fix. And take three more breaths, three chances to be totally here. Breathe in fully. Empty completely. Press into your hands and make your way into your counter pose on this side. And then, yogis, it's time. Let's get upside down. I'm going to speak to dolphin and headstand. Those set up the same-ish. If you're working something outside of dolphin or headstand, feel free to do your thing. You are in your own home, so you get to make that choice, yeah? Forearms down, stack your elbows underneath your shoulders and interlace your hands out in front of you. Dolphin, tuck your toes, lift your knees, and take your gaze towards the middle of your mat, lengthening your neck like your spine. Headstand, most of you are there, some of you working on it. You'll walk in so that your hips are stacked over your shoulders. You can pull your knees into your chest like a little egg stand and take your feet up at the same time. You can take one leg up and then the other. And the goal for both dolphin and headstand, at least on my mat and in my brain and body, is the strongest legs I can make. The stronger my legs, the happier my shoulders, the more lift I have. Dolphin, press your chest towards your inner thighs. Like imagine someone's head in your thoracic spine, gently pushing your sternum towards your inner thighs. Yes, Lisa S. Nice, Ellie. And if you have more to offer, walk your feet in a little. Hips more over your shoulders. Headstand, lift your feet a little higher. Three or four more breaths. From a place of yes. Take a full breath in. Very gently, lower to supported child's pose, knees and feet close. Tops of your feet on the mat, reach your hands back by your toes. Can be really still here, your thighs supporting your upper body, or a little gentle rock side to side might feel nice as well. And breathe in. Empty out. Make your way up to sit. All right, so we are going to do Janyu Shirsasana here today. Bent legs, seated forward fold. Once your feet are stretched out near the top edge of your mat, keep your left leg straight. Bend your right knee like you're moving into tree pose. Push your right foot into your straight left leg. Anchor through both sit bones. Root down. Inhale, reach up. Keep your spine long, fold over your left leg. Now notice I did not say you're locked out perfectly straight left leg. If your left hamstrings are tight, put a softness behind your knee. Keep the length in your spine instead. Longer spine inhale. Deeper fold exhale. Nice. Two more breaths. Longest spine, deepest fold. Make your way upright to sit. Switch your legs. Straighten your right leg. Bend your left knee. John, you here. Again, sit bones grounded. Inhale, reach your hands up towards the ceiling or sky. Fold over your straight right leg. Breath in to lengthen. Uddiyana Bandha to fold a little more deeply, right? Pull the pit of your belly in. It gives you access to go a little deeper. And two more breaths, lengthen. Fold. And last one. Deepest fold. Make your way up to sit. Stretch both feet out in front of you. Paschimottanasana for three breaths. Bring your big toe mounts close. Put a little space between your heels. Reach up. Bow over both of your legs. Three breaths. Inhale. Belly to spine fold. Let the weight of your head drop. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more big breath. Deepest fold. All right, come upright to sit. Reverse plank or tabletop before we move to your back. Bend your knees for tabletop and plant your feet underneath your knees. Or zip your legs, point your toes for plank. Plant your hands, press down and rise up. Push through your hands, push through your feet. They're active no matter your shape. Lift your hips a little higher from rooting down. Two more breaths. Strong legs. And last one. Very slowly lower to your backside and then roll all the way down on your whole back. And once you are on your back, pull your knees into your chest. Big squeeze. Happy baby or cobbler. You can separate your knees, grab the inside edges of your feet for happy baby. Excuse me, the outside edges of your feet. Bring your soles to touch if you prefer cobbler here. I actually like both. So that's an option too. And Ellie's rocking her baby. And so are both Lisa's and two Jennifer's at least. Jennifer V, I can't see you, but I know your baby is happy. Take one more breath, everyone. Empty all of your air and stretch out for final rests. Take your time here. You guys are at home, so plenty of space. Take your feet wide. Let your toes drift towards the edges of your mat. Turn your palms face up and snuggle your shoulders underneath you. Take a big breath in through your nose. Open your mouth and let the air out. Do that one more time. Big breath in. Open your mouth, sigh it out. Rest. Let it go. And bring some movement into your body slowly. And perhaps a bigger stretch. And pull your knees into your chest. And with your eyes closed, roll over onto your right side and pause right there for just a moment to notice how you feel. And press into your hands and make your way up to sit. Eyes still closed. Sit up nice and tall. And connect your hands right at the center of your chest. And turn the corners of your mouth towards your eyes. Acknowledge your awesome work. Like this moment to take care of yourself and the space to do it. And let's close the way we began. A single om together. Take a full breath in. Empty all of your air. Breathe in for om. Ah. Bring your thumb knuckles to forehead center. Together we say, Namaste. Good work, you guys. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks, Sarah.
Thanks,
Thank
Kim.
You.
Thanks, Kim.
I hope the rest of your Monday is superb, people.
Thank it was you. Great. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye, Jane. Bye, Jessica.
Bye.
Bye, Jennifer S. and Beth.
Bye.
Bye,
Kim.
Bye, Katie G. Bye. Ah.